Good evening. Our Mass is being offered for the people of the parish. Just one note. We're going to sing Come to the Stable, and after we're finished, when Father is right before the Gloria, we're going to sing a verse of O Come All Ye Faithful, which is number 333 in our Mass book, from number 333.
In such a place of rest. Thank you. O God, who have made this most sacred night, reigning with the splendor of the true light, grant, we pray, that we who have known the mysteries of his light on earth may also delight in his gladness in heaven, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwell in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing. As they rejoice before you, as at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils, for the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaker, you have smashed as on the day of Midian. For every boot that tramped in battle, every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us. Upon his shoulder dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful. From David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains, by judgment and justice, both now and forever, the zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is number 75 in our hymnals. Today our Savior is born. Our response is 75.
Gave himself for us to deliver us from all lawlessness and cleanse
for himself a people as his own, eager to do what is good. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My generation will probably remember some of this.
I wish I knew more about St. Clair that I could relate it to the town. But as you know, I grew up in Pottsville. And as a young boy, this was a very exciting time for me. Because there were all kinds of stores on Center Street. And they weren't puffy smoke shop, and they weren't tattoo parlors, and they weren't lottery ticket places. They were bona fide businesses. And I remember right before Christmas, going Christmas shopping with uncles and aunts into all those different shops. You remember how the streets of Pottsville used to bustle? And it was even more magical if there was light snow coming and everybody was in a wonderful mood. And then, of course, there was the arrival of Santa Claus. How many of us remember the window display at Congress? Where you go across the street to the Sears building and they have all the latest toys in the window and all the latest craftsman's tools for the bigger kids. And they'd block off between Pomeroy's and the Water Authority, that entire block. And the Phoenix Hook and Ladder would come in and they'd put the ladder up to the roof of the Sears building. And you'd hear an announcement go, "Santa's sleigh has just been spotted over Yorkville. Santa's sleigh is over Garfield Square. And now Santa's sleigh is circling the Sears building. And jolly old St. Nick is putting on his parachute, and he's going to jump out of the sleigh, and he's going to land on the Sears building." And then all of a sudden you see the jolly old elf pull over the side of the precipice, and everybody would start to cheer. And the Pottsville High Band was there, and the Tivity's Band was there, and the 3rd Brigade Band was there, and everybody would start singing, "Here Comes Santa Claus." I really don't know how he did it because, you know, Santa Claus is up in years. But you see him throw his legs over the top of that precipice and he climbed down that ladder and he's waving and he's ho-hoing. There used to be a parade. And the parade would take him to a throne. And all the good little boys and girls would line up to tell him what they wanted for Christmas. And if you're really good, you went to Rodmush's Bakery. And you got a cup of hot chocolate and a cookie. Great memories. Great memories. And guess what? Rodmush's is closed. Sears is closed. Pomeroy's is closed. They won't let Santa Claus parachute out of the reindeer sleigh anymore from down the ladder because it's a legal liability with the insurance company. Nobody's going to give you a good cup of hot chocolate anymore. You might get the crap that's mixed with hot water and some powdered stuff. Fond memories, but they're in the past. Never to be repeated again. And then, of course, there are those that are already looking to next Christmas. Well, very sadly, the older we get, the harder it seems to be to satisfy our needs and the needs of others. And we begin saying, "Well, I didn't get the cookies baked this year, I didn't get the cards out, the packages, well, I went and got those Santa Claus gift bags with the tissue paper, I put them in there, because I didn't have time to wrap, and Santa Claus's elves were just too busy to wrap those packages for me." Remember how they put the nurse's corners on those packages, you know, how miraculously wrapped they were? Next Christmas will be better. to have hope. And we need to see and pray that every day is going to be better. But our Christmas for us is right now. You know, it was nice this morning seeing the light snow coming down. And I was thinking to myself, why couldn't this be as we're leaving the 8 o'clock Mass tonight? Wouldn't that be so magical? Wouldn't that be so warm and rock metal? Instead, Mary Lou will probably be playing as a recessional hymn, Raindrops Keep Falling in My Head. We have to live now. Because if we try putting off tomorrow, or we try living in the past, we're wasting our time. We're wasting our lives. What does living now mean in the present? It means that the power of God will never take us, for He is not with us. The love of God will never be less than the amount of love we need. The mercy of God will always be more abundant than any wrong we have done. And knowing that God is there. There was nothing on TV last night. It was too late for me to put in one of my Scrooge movies. And please don't tell anybody, but I was watching EWTN. But there was a great commentary on the Christmas readings. Something I never thought about. Why, in the Gospel of Matthew, do they say that there was no room in the inn? What does that symbolize? Does it literally mean that there was no room in the inn? Maybe. But the evangelist was trying to tell us there was no place for Jesus to go because people were rejecting him. They wouldn't welcome him into their hearts, into their lives, into their minds. Do we do that? When life is good, we give no thought to Jesus at all. When life is bad, we're moaning and groaning because we want him to hurry up. We want him to fix things rather than ask for him to be by our side. When we're hurting, when we're in pain, we never ask him for strength. We ask for him to take the pain away. When there's something that we don't like, we go back to good old days. That they really never were good old days. Or we dream into the future. Things will never come. As many of you know, a very dear friend of mine died of COVID this week. And I'm crushed. At least once a month we spend 20 minutes together. Most of that was related around church. And there'd always be affirming texts from him. You call me brother. When I got the text that he was in the ER, he was asking for prayers. Bill, pray for me. I got the COVID. Msgr. So John, hang in there. And for 4 days, we text back and forth. And it got to the point, I was trying to make him laugh, or make a joke out of the fact that there were so many people backed up in the emergency room because of COVID, and he was still waiting for a bed. He got his bed in intensive care only because he couldn't breathe. And a few hours later, he died. That could be any one of us. We have a parishioner now in the parishioner medical center under very similar circumstances, intubated on a ventilator. So if we're worried about what we're going to do tomorrow, when we're all wrapped up in about what happened yesterday, but we want to live in the past, good for you. Guess what? You're missing the most important time of your life right now. You're missing your life. You're missing the life that Jesus came to bring us. Yeah, days can get sucky and days can get bad. Days can be full of sorrow, days can be full of heartbreak. Days can be full of frustration and anxiety and anger. God is there. We just reject him. We don't know he's there. We put up the sign, no room in the inn. God, I'm too busy to think about you right now. God is there. And his favor rests on you and me. There's going to be tougher days ahead. But there's also going to be good days ahead. There's weddings. There's babies to be born. There's a little baby that we should all be smiling at right now. Because it's a sign of life. It's a sign of life for us as a people of God. God can't live in our lives. We put up the known sign. God can't be alive if we live in the past and in the future. And God touch our hearts and our minds this Christmas. Not for miracles, not for better days, but for him to help us realize that we are his brothers and sisters. And he holds his hand out so that we can hold his hand. And we hold our hands out to everyone here in this church and saying, I love you and I support you because just like me, you were born a son, a daughter of God.
I believe in one God. Seated at the right.
come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in the one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess all baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
On this blessed night, we rejoice because our Savior has been born. Let us pray for the Father who has shown his endless love by sending us his only Son.
For the leaders of our church, especially our Holy Father, Pope Francis, that through their work, they may continue to spread the good news of our Savior. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the members of our church, throughout the world, that they may share the joy of this holy night, and rejoice in the light of faith. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all mothers, that they may follow the example of Blessed Mary, who so lovingly welcomed the infant Christ into her life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our community, especially parents and children, that all families may appreciate the true spirit of Christmas giving. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the souls of all who share our Christmas joy in times past on earth, that they may come to eternal glory, let us praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for an end of the coronavirus, and especially we pray for all healthcare workers, especially our nurses who are working this battleground. May God give them strength and perseverance. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, you sent your only Son into the world, truly God and truly man. Mindful of your great gift, we confidently place our needs before you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our hymn is number 341, Angels We Have Heard on High. Hymn number 341.
Thank you.
sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept our sacrifice in your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all the souls of the church.
As we look forward, O Lord, to the coming festivities, may we serve you all the more eagerly for knowing that in them you make manifest the beginnings of our redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exalted in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, bless
Joseph, her chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles of St. Clare of Assisi, and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace.
And if you'd be kind enough to light your congregational tapers off of the candles that the altar servers have. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, that we who are gladdened by participation in the feast of our Redeemer's Nativity may, through an honorable way of life, become worthy of union with him who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May the God of infinite goodness, who by the incarnation of his Son
has driven darkness from the world, and by that glorious birth has illumined this most holy night. Drive far from you the darkness of vice, and illumine your hearts with the light of virtue forever and ever.
Amen.
May God, who willed that the great joy of his son's saving birth be announced to shepherds by the angel, fill your minds with the gladness he gives, and make you heralds of his gospel forever and ever.
Amen.
And may God, who by the incarnation brought together the earthly and heavenly realm, fill you with the gift of his peace and favor, and make you sharers with the church in heaven forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, descend upon you and remain with you forever and ever.
Amen.
A blessed Holy Christmas to all of you.
Merry Christmas.
Our hymn is number 336, Joy to the World, verses 1, 2, and 4, and number 336.